Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. People like you and me are often name-called. We're called fear-mongers or paranoid. We're asked questions like, why do you feel the need to carry a gun on you? You know, you've made it this far in life. Don't you think that you're going to be fine without a gun? Or we're told, you have a better chance of survival without your gun because the mere fact that you have a gun makes it more dangerous for yourself and those around you. We hear this kind of stuff all the time, but yet there's something inside of us that constantly tells us we have to defend ourselves and our family, especially with somebody else who has a weapon, okay? Be it a knife, a bat, a gun, it doesn't matter. You know, we have to do this. And then we see a story that took place like this in Tulsa, Oklahoma, where a guy's out mowing his lawn and three brothers step up on this guy. One's a 20-year-old, a 17, and a 15-year-old guy. The 20-year-old has a gun on him, right? Broad daylight, they step up on this guy who's mowing his lawn and they rob him. They walk out with 12 bucks and a debit card, all right? So it wasn't a very successful robbery, but nonetheless, broad daylight, very bold, they do this. So they go down the road and they see another guy. He's out watering his lawn, right? He's got his hose and the spigot. He's watering his lawn, and they decide to do the same thing with this guy. Except for the 20-year-old stays in the car, the 17 and the 15-year-old come step up on this guy, and he draws a gun. All right, now he was armed. He was able to end this scenario without having to pull the trigger. However, it did take him between 5 and 7 seconds to get the gun out of the holster. I'm sure he was nervous. I'm sure he may have been shaking a little bit, but I would just suggest, you know, practice that draw a little bit, get a little more fluid with it, and fall back on your training. So we need to keep that in mind as well. But he did have a gun on him, end of the situation. This was all captured on a doorbell camera that he had, and the police had a description of the car and facial recognitions of the one person that was involved. They got caught not long after that. The 15-year-old jumps the fence of one of the neighbors, and the guy from that house shot him. Now he's gonna be okay. All right, it's suspected that he's going to be fine, but he's also arrested for armed robbery. All right, now people watching this, people who are familiar with the story, are going to say, well, he was just a 15-year-old, he didn't need to be shot, that's excessive. We don't know if he had a bat, a knife, if he threatened this guy. You know, you're out with your family, maybe the kids are playing in the yard or something, and some kid jumps over your fence. You know your defenses are going to go up. And you're gonna be like, no, 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 this isn't happening right now. And so he shoots him, all right? Now, he also did the right thing. Police came, they arrested him, as we should expect, but he said, you know what, I was in fear for my life, and I won't say another word until I am in the presence of my attorney, which is the exact thing we are supposed to say. I was in fear for my life, and I will fully cooperate, but not until I have my attorney present. That's it. And you don't say another word. And that's what he did. And we'll see what happens when he goes in front of a judge, if he, you know, gets further charged or they drop the case. We don't know if these kids were problems within the neighborhood all along. Something tells me that's the case. But the fact is, you never know when something bad is going to happen. All right, you never know. It could be in your own house. I don't care how many times people say, you know, you're paranoid, you don't need to do this, it's a big pain, why you do it? It doesn't matter what people say. The fact is that we had two situations, one where a guy was unarmed, so we think, all right, or didn't want to deal with shooting a kid over 12 bucks, and then we have another case where a guy was armed and these kids eventually got caught. You know what? They had a gun. You don't know their ages. It doesn't matter what their ages are. They were dangerous people, and right now they're sitting in a jail cell. So don't let people tell you that you're paranoid or you're a fearmonger, because you have the good sense of mind to protect yourself and your family. If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.